A little light is being shed on peace talks between Colombia's government and the Revolutionary Armed Forces of Colombia. After 2 years of closed-door negotiations in Cuba, both sides have published part of their draft peace agreement. As CCTV correspondent Michelle Begue reports, the goal is to bring transparency to the process.
At the 69th UN General Assembly, Colombian President Juan Manuel Santos had a message of hope for his country and the international community.
Today, I can tell the international community that we are closer than ever at achieving peace. The process that we have been going through in Havana for the last 2 years with the FARC guerrilla has been serious, realistic, dignified, and efficient, and has concrete advances.
President Santos mentioned the joint decision to publish the accords agreed to so far between the government and the rebel group Revolutionary Armed Forces of Colombia. The full 65 pages of text on three topics, land, political participation of the rebel group, and narco-trafficking, had not been disclosed until now. The government said it was a move to counter misinformation spread by opponents against the talks.
Opponents of the process have taken advantage of the general ignorance that exists in press releases and reports. They circulate all kinds of stories and rumors to try and misinform, to try and create mistrust. None of it is based on the text of the agreement.
In Colombia, politicians who are usually vocal opposers to the peace talks have remained silent since the publishing of the agreement, only mentioning they will study the text in depth. The peace documents offer some details of post-conflict programs that include a land fund for poor farmers, but details on the amount of government financing needed were not specified. The FARC also pledged to help eradicate illegal crops such as coca once the agreement is signed.
A Colombia without coca and without conflict was an impossible dream just a few years ago, or decades. Today I can tell you that it is a real possibility.
Meanwhile, in Havana, negotiations continue privately on the final two topics of victims' reparations, followed by the demobilization of rebel fighters. Any deal made in these negotiations will have to be put up for a referendum vote before it can be made into law. Michelle Begue, CCTV, Colombia.